Hey everybody, Don here with SDI. Today we're out filming some B-roll and we have a couple drones with us. We have a Matrice 350 RTK and we have a Mavic 3. Now I've flown plenty of drones in my career, but this is the first time that I'm gonna be laying eyes on these particular models that we have next to us. And this honestly is the first time that I'm flying here in this airspace. So the first thing that I wanna do before I even pull out the drones is I wanna check the airspace that I'm in and make sure that I file my LAANC request. So to file a LAANC request, what you wanna do is you wanna go to your phone and there's a particular app that I like to use. It's called Aloft Air Control. And I'm gonna pull that up for you guys. And you can see here on screen, we are just inside of airspace here. So I know that I'm close to an airport. It's about 3 to 5 miles away. There's the Glendale Airport over there. And we are at a location at a particular park, and it looks like we are just literally inside of the grid. Okay, so we have to file a LAANC request because we're in there. But if you look closely, we can get authorized up to 400 feet. So when you click over here on this LAANC icon, you can file LAANC requests either 44809, which is recreational, or you can file for Part 107 commercial. Since I'm an employee at SDI and I work under their organization, that's what I'm gonna use. So Part 107 commercial, and then you just slide the bar up to 400 feet. And since the Class G airspace, you can see, which is right outside on the right-hand side of that grid, we're covered up to 400 feet. And even inside the grid, we're covered. So this is the area that we're gonna operate in. And as soon as you apply for your waiver, you click next. We're gonna be flying for roughly about 2 hours. So we'll hit next. And then here it says we are eligible for auto approval. And then click next, agree and submit. And there we go. And in about a couple seconds, I should get an auto text message generated to my phone saying that I'm approved. And I am. So there's my LAANC request. Now that I'm approved up to 400 feet, the next step is to move on to the pre-flight checks of the drones. So we're connected for a while now. We've got some satellites popping up. And even though me as a pilot, I filed LAANC requests and I've gotten approval to fly in this area, DJI also has their own FlySafe geo database. And I'm gonna show you what that looks like, because if you ever run into this issue where you filed your LAANC request, but then your drone won't take off because it says takeoff not permitted, this is usually the reason why. And it makes the most sense here if you can see on screen. I'm just at the edge of airspace here. So it's in a yellow, meaning like a warning or a caution zone, and I can fly. But let's say I had a certificate of authorization that I got approved at like an airport where it was a zero grid. Even though I have LAANC requests, me as a pilot, DJI has their own FlySafe database. So you would actually have to go in and unlock that yourself. Over here on the left, you can see that it's a red zone, and that's exactly where the runway is. So if I was flying over there, I would not only have to do a LAANC request, but I would also have to unlock my drone to do it that way. So let's move on to the pre-flight check. So before we do our pre-flight check, I wanna check my camera settings. Now today is a bright day, like I said. We have an ND64 on here. I personally think that's gonna be a little bit too dark if we're not shooting in auto. So let me show you on screen here what we have. And if you look here on screen, we're at double the shutter speed. So we're shooting at 4K 60 right now, and our shutter speed is set to 1/120, which makes sense. That's where you wanna be. So ideally, if you look at the EV compensation, we're at -1.7. So a 64 is a little bit dark. In this case, I would probably choose potentially like a 32. Most likely it's gonna be a 16. And our aperture is set to 5.6, our ISO is 400. So we're good there, except we're just a little bit dark. So in this case, since we don't have a 16 or a 32, I'm gonna be on the safe side and I'm gonna shoot in auto. So we're gonna do a quick pre-flight check here. Just make sure the props are good. There's no cuts or scrapes on either of the props. Looks good. Looks good. Now I'm pretty much ready to take off, but before I do, like I said, this is the first time that I've flown here. So I gotta ask myself this question and not get overly excited about launching the drone and taking off. What's gonna happen if I lose my signal? Well, I gotta know the settings that I'm supposed to change. I don't know the integrity of the Wi-Fi around here. I know we're at a park and there's a lot of homes over there, but I wanna know exactly what the drone's gonna do if I lose signal. And on top of that, I'm allowed up to 400 feet, so I don't want my drone going above 400 feet. So let me get a screen recording going and I'll show you how that works. So up here in the upper right of the screen, you can see either there's the three dots there. You're gonna click on that and then you're gonna go to the safety section. So I'm gonna quickly scroll through this and make sure that it's set the way I want it to set. Obstacle avoidance is set to brake. That's good because I don't know this area. I don't know what's beyond those trees over there. So I'm gonna play it safe this time. Advanced RTH is set to preset. Now, preset and optimal, there's two different things. Optimal is like, it's like a trail of breadcrumbs. So if you lose signal, it's gonna fly that same path back home. In this instance, I can look out and I can say, okay, well, the trees, they're a maximum of 40 feet, but I know that there's a pole over there that sits quite high. Now, I don't plan on flying over there, but I wanna clear every single obstacle that I have in my flight path. So I'm gonna set it to preset and I'm gonna drop that altitude down to a safe bet of about 150 feet. That'll work. And so I know what it's gonna do if I lose signal. It's gonna come back, beeline home at 150 feet. Pretty safe for this area. Now the max altitude here on this settings, because this is the first time I've flown this drone, we wanna set that to 400 feet because we're authorized up to 400 feet in this grid. So I'm gonna drop that down to 400 feet. There we go, 393 will work. And then the max distance, I'm gonna keep it in line of sight, so I'm not gonna limit that right now. But yeah, everything checks out good. Nothing we have to worry about, just those two settings. You definitely wanna check your airspace, right? And then check your altitude and what it's gonna do in the event you lose signal. So with that said, I think we're ready to take off. Taking off. All right, guys, you're approved here to fly. You've done your pre-flight check. You have your visual observer, Christian in my case, and now it's time to have some fun. For more information on our drone programs, check out sdi.edu.